Hey you, yeah you. Before we get this video started, I just want to say a thank you for those who have been a member of my Patreon. If you want to be a member of my Patreon, leave a link in the description down below right here. And there's a list right here of all the people who have been a member or a following member of the Patreon to help keep this channel alive. I would appreciate it if you do show your support, guys. You guys are awesome, and I really thank you for your support. Also, commissions are open, so if you want a commission for me to draw something for you, go to my DeviantArt page right here as well in the link in the description, and I'll draw something for you, but make sure you hopefully follow the rules in my Patreon on my Patreon and commission so we can get it on the list for me to draw something for you guys. I would really appreciate it if you do, and yeah. As always, take care, have a great day, and let's start the video, shall we? What is up, YouTube? Frost the Hobbit in here, and we're back for another death race, and this death race is going to be a death race number two is what I'm going to call it. And it's going to have a lot, there's a lot of competitors here, besides the one that says Optimus Prime versus Thomas the Tank Engine. So go check out the original video first before checking out this video reaction, before seeing my reaction. And you know, hopefully I'm trying to get these videos done as quick as possible. I'm still playing catch up. It's been very difficult for me and slow, but I'm doing the best I can, and I really appreciate all the support you have done for me. You guys are amazing, and I hope you enjoy this reaction video. There are some videos who have been requested. Ingazilla, I know you want to see that Dungeon Dynamite reaction. I got it up and ready. It's just a very long video, and it will be uploaded soon. So be patient, buddy. I'll get it done before the end of the month. Alright, by the meantime, enjoy this little death race by Screw Attack reaction. Please support Screw Attack and Death Battle, as well as I will continue to support them as well. As always, let's get this death race started, shall we? In 3, 2, 1, go!
This episode of Death Race is brought to you by DoorDash!
DoorDash. I might have to skip the DoorDash sponsorships. And just get straight to the race. Okay, your hair is pink now. Hello and welcome. Like I'd always. You always change your color shade.
Where the only rule is do anything you can to come in first. Or, don't die. Gotta be honest, we kinda have to wait and see how things shake out day to day. But no matter
what, we shall bid the train. Yeah, I'm trying to recover.
And that's a metaphor for blood, by the way. Because today's cars are alive, I tell you. Alive.
Okay, calm down, buddy.
Man, I gotta stop drinking absinthe before shows.
Good advice. I'm drinking Propel Gatorade water. This simple Freightliner, my favorite kind of water. My truck exterior belies the heart and soul of a warrior and the body of a giant robot. My hero.
Despite being from an alien planet, he's 100% American. You can tell from the red, white, and blue and the brutal murder of an anime pretty boy.
Wow.
Cheating. If he ever did
that, is true.
Right there. Even if it's only a video game.
That is true. He has a habit of that.
They look like your box standard Ford Anglia.
Oh, for all the J.K. Rowling fans out there.
Magic, this baby can fly and even turn invisible. And best of all, trapped inside are two terrified miners, fresh out of Hogwarts on summer break. Hey, if you win the race.
Oh no, adding Ron and Harry in this.
One of them doesn't even have parents.
Oh no, don't even joke about that.
He's the number one locomotive.
Why Thomas?
Just look at him, he's a sweetheart. Nothing sinister hides behind those moon-shaped, dopey, soul-piercing eyes. No horrors buried beneath the...
I'm terrified.
...blue sheets of steel.
The real Thomas is not terrifying.
This red-hot race car got a second lease on life.
Ka-chow!
Oh, we're doing this now.
Radiator springs and it's a...
Gotcha!
Alright, let's just... Let's join our commentators, Wiz and Boomstick, before the race. I'm coming down anyways.
Just like before, whoever makes it to the end first wins, but we don't care how they get there.
Alright.
Aliens on the track this time, Boomstick?
Not this time, Wiz. Unless good. You want another blood bet.
Maybe I should just go climb down there myself.
I'm not stopping you. But we don't need civilians because the...
Okay, then you must be really confident. No innocent people in there.
Death, can one truly grapple with the beauty of mortality? Man, I need to stop drinking absinthe before these shows. Right, Talking Shoulder Gremlin? Same.
Do you even know what that word means, or are you just repeating things you hear?
That's what I want to know.
Show?
The race is about to begin, but first a word about our gracious sponsor, DoorDash.
Skip! All right, we're back. Let's go. You skip that. Of course, Lightning would say ka-chow.
They're off, and wow, Thomas takes an early lead. Impressive, considering there aren't any train tracks.
Oh, yeah.
I think that's gonna be a problem.
Yeah, it is. There are no train tracks here.
Can't go around the bends like that, Tommy.
But no, you can't.
Neck and neck, coming upon the first real obstacle, the tunnel. Optimus goes in first. It's gonna be a tight fit in there.
That's what she said.
I knew you would make a joke about that.
Unconventional route.
What do you expect, Liz? Those kids should not be driving.
They shouldn't be.
Making McQueen's life miserable in that tunnel. He's gonna have to pull off something.
Nice move, Lightning McQueen. Too bad your sequel movie sucks. Oh, I'm sorry. Is that a I'm sorry. Did I insult you?
You know, I think having a car that flies kind of defeats the point of all this.
Pretty much. Nice one. Uh-oh.
Whoa, I knew he was pissed, but OP's out for blood. Or oil. Does Lightning bleed?
As we move down the track, we approach another deadly obstacle. The Whopping Willow.
Of course you would make that obstacle. Harry Potter and in the Chamber of Secrets reference. Nice moves, Lightning. Oh.
Clearly has nothing to do with Decepticons, Wiz, but I respect his gumption.
Wow.
So, taken out of context, it almost sounds sort of robo-racist.
Dirty, filthy, stinking Decepticons!
Calm down, Optimus. You don't usually act this way.
Okay, who turned on the scary
mod? Oh, crap. Who turned on the scary mod? That's funny. Oh, that was dark.
Man, I need to stop drinking absinthe before shows.
You drink to come on, Optimus. You've also set a good example. Okay, bye-bye, Thomas. And Lightning McQueen is dead.
The winner is my boy, Optimus Prime!
Ah, Boomstick, I was afraid of this.
See, Optimus Prime's victory may be clear, but he won through sheer luck and brutality.
By
his own standards, he cheated and must now commit Autobot seppuku.
Oh, Optimus. You made a lot of children cry doing this.
Goodbye, Wings of Iron. You were the light in our darkest hour.
What was there to gain from all this?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Ah, it still counts. Hey, come back next time for another...
He still wins the race. Well, that was a lot of fun. Okay, go. Okay, that was, Death Race number 2. And I'm going to freeze it at this part where Optimus is about to commit suicide here due to he lost the race. And yeah, I think that was a bit of a disturbing image there because, I'm with Boomstick here. His face expression pretty much says it all. Like, no, he won the race. Don't do it. Anywho, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little Death Race battle. Death Race battle reaction video. I hope you please support Rooster Teeth for these guys. These guys done an amazing job on this. Let me know in the comments down below what your thoughts on this race. If you're a Harry Potter fan, if you're a Thomas the Tank Engine fan, a Cars fan, or a Transformers fan, and then those Cars fans out there who kind of was insulted that little joke about his sequel movies not doing so well, my apologies. I was just joking around. My bad. I mean, no disrespect out of it. Anywho, take care, have a great day, be safe, and most importantly, stay frosty and stay healthy out there. Take care.
Let me be the point man. I thought the Earth wasn't supposed to move until the honeymoon.